I'm Dan Aykroyd. In addition to my work as a writer and actor, I have also pursued a lifelong interest in the supernatural and the paranormal. The following story is inspired by such events and is taken from the actual case files of the Office of Scientific Investigation and Research.
Sounds like we're getting close.
You okay, Gail?
Wild animals creep me out.
I meant your leg.
Still hurts.
Here.
No, thanks.
Take the edge off the pain. Gary?
Not while I'm on duty.
Right. Well, suit yourself. Stop pointing that thing at me, Gary.
Dousing himself with gasoline.
Quiet.
He's gonna light himself on fire.
We gotta stop him or something. He's gonna kill himself.
That's all right.
Gretta, Gail!
Mr. Thompson! Please stop! Mr. Thompson, stop, please! Mr. Thompson, please! Please stop, okay? You don't have to. What are you doing? You don't have to. Oh, Jesus!
I'll kill you!
From the team came in at noon yesterday.
No wonder Anton was so stressed out over the phone. Three missing operatives? It's a sensitive situation.
It started out a fairly straightforward case, an unverified wild man sighting.
Until they found a dismembered corpse. A couple of locals went missing. So what's your take on this case manager? What's his name? Brett Watterson?
I trained with Brett. He's a damn good investigator.
Apparently there's been some complaints about his conduct.
There have always been complaints about Brett. He's not exactly what you would call orthodox.
So what about the rest of the team?
We've got Gail Mitchell. Now she's a new recruit. Physics grad, top of her class.
Gotta like that.
And Gary Watson, 6 years with the OSIR.
Yeah, I met Gary a couple times at HQ. Seems like a good guy.
It's a good team. Now, if there was any way for Brett to keep in touch with HQ, he would have.
Maybe they just got lost in the woods.
I hope you're right. There's their mobile lab.
Hello?
Hello? Brett?
Gary, Gail?
Lights are out.
Shh. Listen. You hear anything?
Nothing.
Generator must be down. All right, let's go to comm lines. I'm gonna go check it out.
All right. Trashed. God, it's like a tornado hit in here.
Yeah, the same thing goes for the electrical system. It's thoroughly ripped up. Any signs on your end what caused the damage?
Well, it's hard to tell. Any chance we'll get some more light in here?
I'm gonna have to run AC direct from the second generator. Make do as best I can.
All right. Looks like they found something. The remains are human. So's the blood.
Oh, boy. I found their digital case logs. Looks like a complete record of the investigation up until 3 days ago.
Well, this is the place.
Okay. Just tell us what happened.
My husband and our boy, they went out hunting. That was 3 days ago, just for the day, right? And they didn't come back. Well, when it got on past dinner, I thought they might have had trouble with the truck, so I drove out looking for them. And then I heard a rustling in the bush, just back of here. I called out, but there was no answer, so I thought the worst. I got the flashlight from the car, and I walked back. I didn't see anything. Then there was a howl behind me. And then this creature came out of the woods running just right at me.
What happened then?
Well, I ran. It was right behind me. I didn't think I was going to... Well, I made it back to the car.
Can you describe exactly what you saw?
It was big. Well over 6 feet and hairy. Furry.
The RCMP say there have been grizzlies spotted up here lately. You'd recognize a bear like that, wouldn't you?
Oh, it ran like a man, not a bear. I seen plenty of bear, and that was no bear. It was a Sasquatch. I know what I saw.
Let's see what else we got.
Well, this is the area our eyewitness Heather Buckley swears she saw a Sasquatch. That's her word, not mine. And if that doesn't get her on the news, she'll see an alien by tomorrow.
Well, it could be a Sasquatch.
Manitoba, it's not likely. Besides, Sasquatch are vegetarian.
Maybe tofu is a little hard to come by out here.
So if you don't think she saw anything...
I didn't say that.
Okay, well, what are we looking for out here?
Fur, torn clothes. Maybe a body. Tell me something. What do you know about lycanthropy?
Werewolf.
Werewolf?
Gail? Gary? Gary, get over here.
Give me a shot of this, will you?
Human bones.
No kidding.
What's he doing carrying a gun?
He's investigating a possible werewolf sighting.
Yeah, but why not stick to protocol and use a trank gun?
Oh, Brett would never put his team at risk.
Well, if you ask me, taking a gun to an interview is pretty risky.
Hold it. No. Stay here. I'll handle it. Stay here. Down here and help me, will you?
What are you doing here?
Can you help me?
Is this your trap?
Who the hell are you?
OSIR.
Another freaking branch of government. Like we don't have enough regulations around here.
No, we're
Office of Scenery, Industry, and Recreation. We're checking hunting licenses.
Damn bureaucrats. I should have left you in the trap.
Samuel Thompson, Cross Lake, Manitoba. Looks in order. Thank you, sir. If you don't mind, we'd like to ask you a few questions.
I do mind.
Mr. Thompson, we just want to ask if you've seen anything unusual.
This is a dangerous place. You hear what I said? Very dangerous place.
Well, that's what we,
Shut up!
Wanted to talk to you about.
Probably call for backup.
What for? What are we gonna tell them? We found some cranky old hermit? No, I don't think it's broken, but we should get some ice on this right away. Will you get that up?
Well, I think we should go talk to Thompson.
We should finish watching the case logs first.
Well, look, we got three missing operatives. I get the feeling Thompson knows what's going on.
Does Thompson look like a werewolf to you?
Werewolf or not, I'd rather talk to him in daylight hours.
There. Brett marked their trails.
So odds are they didn't just get lost.
Not likely.
Maybe it is a Sasquatch. What a stench.
Oh my God. Fingerprints. See who this belongs to.
What do you think we're dealing with? A werewolf or some crazed trapper?
Whatever it is, it sliced off the flesh with a knife. Look at this.
Teeth marks.
And they look human.
Positive ID. Gary Watson is the corpse. I called Anton, let him know.
Check this out.
Cannibal killer?
Samuel Thompson.
He ate another trapper?
All that was left were a bunch of bones.
Why isn't he in jail?
A judge ruled he was insane. Later, a panel of psychiatrists decided that he wasn't.
I suppose people do anything to survive.
According to the RCMP report, Thompson had plenty of supplies.
So, Thompson's our first suspect.
Well, it could explain the bones near his camp.
Let's go find out.
No, let's look at the rest of the case logs first.
If Thompson's the killer, there's no point in wasting time.
I want to be as prepared as possible.
Gail and Brett could still be out there.
Gary's dead. Brett and Gail may be, too.
And what if they're not?
I'm not taking any more risks.
Okay. Let's do it by the book.
We're about 200 meters from Thompson's camp, and we found bones that appear to be human.
I count four femurs. That's two victims.
You think it's the two missing people?
Well, that's the most likely scenario.
I think it's time we called the police.
Not yet.
Why not?
They called us in, remember? This is our kind of job. We can handle it.
What's he saying?
Gary, boost the pickup, will you? This could be important.
We tuggle. We tuggle.
Let it go.
We tuggle.
Yeah, does that mean anything to you?
No. I don't think so.
Okay, let's finish these off.
Brett.
What?
You take another swig of that. I'm reporting you. You got it?
Why don't you just back off?
Look, I've had enough of this, okay? You're putting us all at risk. This is ridiculous.
No, wait a minute. No, this is what field work is all about, Mr. Watson.
Oh, come on. There's protocol.
You want to work in a lab? Fine. Go back and work in a lab. You want to see some field action? Follow my lead and shut up.
No way. What, are you trying to prove something here, or you just want to get us all killed? We need backup.
All right. Your objection is duly noted. It will be in my report. If you don't like the way I work, fine. I don't have a problem with that. So when this case is over, you transfer. Period. End of conversation. Over and out.
Anton. I want you to have a complete record of everything that's happening out here. As you'll be able to see from the tapes, we found human remains all over the place, hanging from trees, burned up in a fire pit, and just left to rot in the woods. Anton, it's about Brett. I don't think I trust his judgment. He's been drinking. He won't listen to us, he won't call for backup, and he refuses to contact the police. Tonight, he expects us to go back to Thompson's camp after midnight, looking for an alleged werewolf. If he keeps this up, I don't think we're going to get out of here alive.
Looks like Gary was right.
Brett's obsessive. He's single-minded. And that's what makes him good at his job. It's also what makes him erratic.
No excuse for drinking on the job.
I don't know. Maybe he's just burned out.
Well, then he should be in therapy and not out in the field.
Let's just find him, all right?
Brett's alive. His career is over.
He's a good investigator, Peter.
Look, Gary Watson's dead. Whatever happened out there, I get the feeling that Brett's responsible.
Killings attributed to werewolves usually turn out to be the work of a serial killer with a taste for human flesh.
I don't find that reassuring.
Well, personally, I'd prefer it if Thompson was a werewolf. At least then, he'd only be dangerous at night.
He should be getting to his camp soon.
Yeah, as long as we're on the right track.
Yeah, we are. Yeah. Come on. Mr. Thompson? Hello? Keep going. me that. We're definitely getting close.
You hear that?
Yeah.
Over there.
Tried to kill me. Oh.
Brett was getting angrier. He was snapping at us, and he just went off by himself all the time. Gary was getting on his nerves, and I just figured he was investigating without us. Gary, sorry, I'm so hungry. Sorry.
It's okay.
Gary figured it was just some private time with the bottle. He thought he was drinking too much, and I think he wanted to get him fired.
Did you see Brett kill Gary?
We were at the camp, Thompson's camp. And Brett just turned on us. He had a knife and he just started chasing us. I just started running. And that's when I heard the scream. I thought Gary was right behind me, but he wasn't. So I went back to where the scream came from. And I saw Gary. There was blood everywhere, and I tried to help him. I didn't know what to do. I've never had a friend die before.
I'm sorry. I know how hard that is. Tell me what you did then.
I ran away, and I've been hiding ever since, just waiting for someone to show up.
Are you okay on your own for a minute?
Oh, yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah.
How's she doing?
Well, I was worried about hypothermia, but she seems okay now, physically anyway.
Now we have two suspects, although my money's on Brett.
She says that Brett did it, but I don't know.
Look, I know Brett was your mentor.
Everything that we have is circumstantial.
We have a testimony from an operative. Why would Gail lie?
I don't know that she's lying, but she's a rookie. She's been traumatized. She may not have all the facts.
All right, fair enough. We've been looking at your digital case logs. There's nothing from the last 3 days. Did you record anything?
I don't know. Or maybe Gary had the camera with him when...
What happened to Thompson?
Brett stabbed him.
Is he dead?
I don't know. He must be dead.
What happened to the body? Where is it?
Back at the camp.
Right, well, let's go see if there's a body there.
Hello, Mr. Thompson?
It smells like gasoline.
He's been gutted. His heart's gone, everything.
Wendigo. Oh my God.
Peter? Ever heard of a Wendigo?
That's like a native Canadian werewolf or something, right?
Well, it's close. According to legend, a Wendigo, or Wataco, as it's known in some dialects, is a cannibal spirit that haunts the Canadian North. Now, it mostly affects hunters. Hunters who have been out in the woods too long.
Like our friend Thompson.
Right. Now, the person develops an insatiable craving for human flesh. During the day, they're perfectly normal, but at night. Now, there was a case right here at Cross Lake at the turn of the century. There was an 82-year-old woman who was possessed by the Wendigo. And she was shot straight through the heart. Her killer was arrested before he could burn her remains. The Cree people believed that the killer was a holy man, protecting the community.
If you're a cannibal, why would you hide in the woods where there's no one to eat?
Because even when they're possessed, they are so desperate to hang on to some shred of humanity that they isolate themselves so they can't hurt anyone. They'll even put up warnings.
Like the hanging bones and skull.
They'll even set themselves on fire and their victims so that the spirit dies with them.
And that would explain the gasoline all over Thompson's remains.
If a Wendigo bites someone, the spirit moves into them.
Has Brett got any bite marks on him?
Give me a minute with him, okay?
Careful, all right?
I will.
Lindsay! Lindsay! Somebody! Lindsay, is it you? You're real?
Yeah, it's me. I'm here.
What's happening? God, I thought I'd lost my mind.
Brett, what happened out there?
We back to Thompson's camp. That's right. I was drinking. Probably too much. I don't remember. There was Gail. Gail. And Gary, are they okay?
Gail's okay. Gary's dead.
What?
Gail says that you killed him.
Oh, God, no.
We found part of his remains here, more out in the woods. His internal organs were missing. He was partially eaten. Brett, do you remember any of this?
No, that's not possible. We went back to the old man's camp. We should never have gone back there.
Brett,
we should have gone back.
Brett,
what's happening?
Focus. You've got to concentrate.
No, we shouldn't have gone back. We shouldn't have gone back to
Thompson. Thompson is dead.
He's dead?
Is Thompson Wendigo?
Wendigo. Now I remember Thompson. He was coming straight at me. You have to kill me.
You're jumping to conclusions.
Before I kill you, you have to shoot me through the heart. You have to burn my remains.
We don't have enough evidence to be sure.
You told me I killed two people. I ate their hearts. You have to stop me.
We'll do this right. We'll be thorough.
Lindsay, have to promise to kill me. Please.
Right. Okay. Thanks, Anton. There's no way a backup team can get here until tomorrow. Talk to me about Brett.
I don't know whether he's entirely lucid. He thinks he's a Wendigo. He wants me to kill him.
Is there somebody there?
It's me.
Gail. Oh, thank God I didn't hurt you. You all right?
I'm fine, Brett. Are you okay?
Get me out of these, Gail. Please, let me go.
Why?
Lindsay won't do it. She's wasting time trying to prove it.
Prove what?
That I'm Wendigo. Come on, you're the only one I can trust, Gail. Please, let me go. We don't have much time. I gotta get back to Thompson's camp. I gotta end this myself, please. Take them off.
Okay, well, let's wait until the backup team arrives. We'll finish our investigation, and then maybe we can move him back to HQ. I mean, if he's just snapped, then hopefully with treatment, we can put him back together again. If not...
doing the right thing.
Gail, what are you doing? He's dangerous.
Peter? Gail? Anton. Yeah, it's Lindsay. Everyone's gone. Peter, Brett, Gail, they're gone.
I figure the Wendigo spirit's already passed into him.
So we have to kill Peter, too.
You have to burn us both. It's the only way. Here. It won't be long.
Spirit entered through the wound. When it ran through Thompson's blood into mine.
Gail. You can't do this. Listen to me.
It's an ice spirit, you know. I actually felt my blood, my heart, my soul turn to ice.
Gail. Listen to me. Help you.
I'm not the one who needs help right now, Peter.
There's another team coming tomorrow. They'll find you. They know all about Wendigo.
A Wendigo named Brett Watterson. And when they arrive, I'll have killed the Wendigo. And I'll probably be crying. Because Brett's dead. And he's killed my good friends, Gary Watson, Lindsay Donner, and Peter Axon.
Gail, you can't do this.
Of course, I'll have to shoot him so there's no problem with forensics. And then I'll have to burn him so they won't know that his heart is just fine. And that's a shame because, you know, I look at Brett and think, I hate to waste food.
No. No, Gail.
Sorry, Peter. But I'm hungry.
Gail. Brett! Brett!
Oh, God, Brett. Thank God you're back.
Brett, there's nothing wrong with you. It's her. She's the Wendigo. Brett, listen to me.
No. Peter, it's you, and it's me.
No. No, Brett, you're making a mistake.
Believe me. I wish I were. Don't make it any harder than it has to be, Peter. Gail. Come on.
I'm not sure if I can do this, Brett.
Yes, you can. You have to, Gail. Now, come on. It's okay. Just do it. Come on, pull the trigger right through the heart. Shoot me! Shoot! Come on, shoot me!
Brett!
Don't try to stop her, Lindsay. It ends here. Then, Peter, we'll both have to die.
It's the only way. shoot them myself.
You're easy.
I'm the senior operative. Anton told me to finish this off no matter what it takes.
I can do it.
I know you can do it. But it's my responsibility.
Through the heart.
Get behind me. Go on, get behind me.
Peter, I'm sorry.
A promise is a promise, Brett. Gary's camera. You did your best.
So did you.
Case manager's final log, Peter Axon reporting. Gale's body was cremated. So was Thompson's. And after 1,000 years of haunting the forests of Manitoba, the Wendigo is finally gone. Our recommendation is that Brett Watterson undergo treatment at headquarters in the hope that he will eventually be able to return to the field to continue his life's work. Axon out.
Paranormal research is defined by its attempts to prove the unthinkable, inquire into the unbelievable, and delve into life's deepest mysteries. Strange truths fascinate and often terrify us. But ask yourselves, if there are powerful forces at work beyond our current sphere of knowledge, are we ready to face such power? Or is it more comfortable not knowing the truth? For Psi Factor, I'm Dan Aykroyd.